Hello everybody, my name is Dr. Markus Kreikebaum. I'm from EBS University of Business and Law in Wiesbaden, Germany. And I'd like to present to you the essentials of our service learning program here at EBS. We prepared a series of 4 lectures for you. The first lecture is about the structure of our program. The second lecture is about how you document your learnings and reflect your learnings while serving. The third lecture is about how you can transfer your insights to other perspectives and other contexts. And the fourth lecture is about how you can deal with value conflicts that may come up in your services or projects. Lecture number 1, a journey into the unknown. Service learning is quite a journey into the unknown, so it is good to prepare yourself a little bit for this journey. Our program is divided into 3 sections. First, you choose a place to serve or a project that you want to engage in, depending on your learning objectives. Secondly, we will ask you to reflect your experience and correlate them with some political, cultural, social, or economical considerations about your project or issue. Finally, we will ask you to demonstrate to us how you can transfer your learnings and how you can use them to tackle value conflicts in a more effective and more strategic way. Our travel offer covers a 3-month period. You will ask to hand in your first learning diaries after 6 weeks so we can see how you're doing in your services or projects. At the mid of the term, we have a midterm workshop or also an individual coaching session where we discuss your problems, your concerns and your issues and set you up for your question regarding your essay. Then you go another 6 weeks and then we have a final wrap-up workshop where we discuss our findings and look at the first transfers of our insights. To continue an existing program, you always need to fill out a service learning entry assignment consisting of 4 short questions that we will ask you at the end of this lecture series. So the whole idea behind our approach is that we want to recognize all those things that we take as granted or given and never reflected upon. And this is because we all live in so-called social comfort zones, where we share the same opinions, the same beliefs, the same values, and the same privileges. So we are not able to see them. We are not able to recognize them. Now, in order to recognize your own privileges, the things that you take as granted before, you need to leave your social comfort zone and go out and encounter people with lesser privileges, with other views and perspectives. Only then it is possible to understand, to recognize our own taken as granted or taken as given presumptions about the world and us. The social other has a different culture. It has a different beliefs, different values. And it opens up the possibility for us to recognize our own beliefs and values in the face of the other. When we encounter different cultures, then we start to ask, what are your power relations? What are your rules and regulations you live by? And that opens up the possibility to see my own rules and regulations, my own power relations I'm living in, which then leads to the 3rd stage, which is a co-creational process. Then we ask each other, what can we do together right now in this situation to improve our situation and to learn more about each other? This is basically the journey, and in the end we will always come back to the land as taken as given, to our own social comfort zones, to our own everyday behavior. But it will be a bit different because we have experienced that this is not all taken as given out there. So we want to explore more about this. In order to choose a good place to serve, you need to come up with the right learning objective for yourself. What is it that you want to learn in this service? If you are, for example, interested to develop your didactical skills, you could choose a mentoring program for kids and youngsters. If you are interested to develop your intercultural skills, you could work with refugees. If you are interested to develop more self-efficacy and to really make an impact into the community, you could work in the senior home. If you like to understand more about life and happiness and how people relate to each other, you could work with handicaps. If you're interested in issues of poverty and sustainability, a soup kitchen would be a great place to serve for you. So there are many, many possibilities, and you can choose one of those possibilities depending on your learning objectives. Thank you for joining and listening. Just go out, have fun and do it, and report your experiences to us.